art neither cold nor hot. I'm rereading now. I would thou wert cold or hot. So then because thou art lukewarm, this is a, someone say, spiritual condition. Our spiritual condition is that we are lukewarm. That is, we are not on fire for God, nor are we altogether, have we altogether given up. So we are in between. And this condition is referred to as lukewarm. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee. That means I am about to vomit. The term spew in Hebrew means I will vomit thee out of my mouth. I will spew thee out of my mouth because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing. This is the attitude of the members of God's church in this dispensation. Are you listening to me? And knowest not that thou art what? Someone shout wretched. And this is the first condition. We're going to go through each of these conditions of the church. Wretched is number one. And we'll give you scripture as to what he is saying concerning each condition that he's going to name here. This is the condition of the church. Now, I didn't say this was your condition. I am not diagnosing any individual's individual personal condition with respect to where they stand spiritually with God. You would have to examine yourself, as Paul said, whether you be in the faith. We're talking about the overall condition of the church. So when you see wretched conditions in the ecclesia, the Greek word ecclesia means in these environments or in these conferences, conventions, and so-called spiritual gatherings where people are saying that they are saved, because today just about everybody said they're saved. The devil says he's saved. Can we say amen? I turned to someone and said, the devil is not saved, but the devil will tell you he is saved. So everyone's talking about saved today, and will argue, fuss, and will cuss to defend their position with respect to their so-called salvation. And this then is to simply let us know that the condition of the church, the so-called church, and I'm dealing with people who are supposed to be baptized and filled, Pentecostals and Pentecostal apostolics in particular. If we will be explicit and specific, I'm talking about so-called apostolics, because even now apostolics are trying to change the liturgy. Liturgy means the form of worship, to worship like everybody else, because apostolics are after the crowd. It used to not be this way, but Pentecostals and Pentecostal apostolics are now interested not in quality, but they're interested in quantity, numbers. Why? Because numbers bring in money, and money brings in things. And this is what the church is focusing on now. Everyone is boasting about what they have, how many cars they drive, their house, the size, prosperity. This is unfortunately going to get nothing but worse. Are you listening to me? So someone shout wretched. Thou art wretched and miserable, number two, and poor, number three, and blind, number four, and naked. Are you listening to me? These are the conditions of the church. Wretched. Romans chapter 7. I'm going to now deal with condition number one, wretched. And yes, tonight I'm teaching doctrine, as I've already established, that you can't be saved without it. So tonight I'm teaching doctrine and plenty of it. And I'm happy to announce that I am. Praise the Lord. Now here is the condition, Brother Will Brown, with regard to the church, the wretchedness of the church. Wretched. Here is the scripture concerning the condition of wretchedness. Romans is an epistle that was written to an integrated church. Excuse me. Romans was the church at Rome, and Rome, Italy, was made up of baptized and filled believers. We know that from the 6th chapter of the book of Romans, where Paul said that we're buried with him by baptism into death. Like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, we also do rise to walk in newness of life. Before he said that, he says, know ye not that so many of us as were baptized into Jesus Christ have put on Christ? So this church here was a church that was established by repentance, water baptism in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, and receiving the baptism of the Holy Ghost or the Holy Spirit. And these were saved Jews and saved Gentiles. A portion of the church was Gentile, a portion of the church was Jew. This was an integrated church of saved Jews and saved Gentiles. Now today, almost every one of us here is a Gentile. Of course, there was one young man here that was a Samaritan. Brother Philip was a Samaritan. He was a mixed Jew. But for the most part, our congregation is made up of Gentiles. This church that Paul wrote to here consisted of saved Jews and saved Gentiles. Occasionally, he was writing to the Jewish element of the church. And then in various scriptures in the book of Romans, you will find that he was addressing the Gentile element. And then on some occasions, he was addressing both. Now, in this particular text, we will determine that as we read. In verse number 18, Romans chapter 7, he is quite frankly addressing the Jewish portion of the church primarily, but he is including the Gentile. Are you listening to me? And he speaks and uses himself as an example in this particular chapter and these particular verses. So now as he writes, verse 18, let us read. For I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing, for to will is present with me, but how to perform that which is good I find not. So he is using himself as an illustration in this particular chapter and verse. For I know, I'm rereading it, that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. Now he will tell us how he knew this. He came to this knowledge in a specific way, in a particular way. Are you listening to me? This knowledge he came to this knowledge through the knowledge of the law of God, the Torah, the Jewish Torah, which is still called the Torah today, was the law of God, and Paul was a member of the Jewish Sanhedrin. And that means, of course, he had been trained at the feet of Gamaliel. He knew the law, that is the Ten Commandments, the 613 ordinances, and of course, the Psalms and the prophets. All of this is spoken of by Jesus in the Gospels, that all of these things must be fulfilled concerning Jesus Christ. Now, Paul, when he is writing here, he is at this time writing the book of Romans. So the book is not complete. We're reading the book after it was completed. But at the time that he was writing this, the book wasn't complete. Therefore, the New Testament wasn't complete. So he is writing, quite frankly, of his own experience and his own testimony. For I know that in me, that is in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing, even though the Jews, I'm not trying to speak disrespect to my Jewish audience, the Jews thought that they were God's gift to the world. They were God's people, the greatest people on the face of the earth. Now he is acknowledging that with the revelation that he has received, he has discovered that regardless of whether he was born a Jew or not, in his flesh, even as a Jew, is what? No good thing. So this is the lesson in this verse. I don't care what your pedigree is, what your genealogy is, it means nothing to God. You still have to be born again. And so boasting one's pedigrees, one's lineage, I'm Irish, Italian, Jewish, what's some of the others? Anglo-Saxon, African-American, whatever, because we get caught up in these things. This is really the phenomenon of Barack Obama. I don't have nothing against Barack Obama, but black folks are just happy to see a black person. I would rather see an apostolic. Can we say amen? I quite frankly, I would. I'd rather see someone baptized and filled with the Holy Spirit running for president and at the head of the Democratic Party, so we wouldn't have to worry about the nonsense that is going on in politics today. Turn to someone and say, that'll never happen. All right, back to reality. But in verse number 18, but how to perform that which is good, I find not, because it is not in us. It is not in you, it is not in me, without the baptism of the Holy Spirit, which we'll get to very shortly, how to perform that which is good according to someone.